This
letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in newness of life. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we should also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. As to his death, he died to sin once and for all. As to his life, he lives for God. Consequently, you too must think of yourselves as dead to sin and living for God in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Receive great human gifts as a result. in spite of all those challenges and risks and rewards and all that uncertainty and all that terrible imperfection and sometimes failure and rejection, will bring the power of God, even the real presence of Christ, in our encounter with others. It's amazing that when we encounter someone else, we can have an experience of Christ Himself. We know the power of that encounter. Remember the interchange between that wise scribe whose heart was open to Jesus? He came up to him and he said, "Good teacher, what is the greatest commandment in the law?" Torah, the law. Jesus said to him, "You shall love the Lord your God with your whole heart, with all your strength." And the scribe replied to Jesus, "Yes, Lord, to love the Lord your God, excuse me, with all your heart, is worth more than any burnt offering or sacrifice." And Jesus said to him, You are not far from the kingdom of God. But what about mother and father and son or daughter, or sister or brother, we might ask? Are they not important to us too? Yes, but they are not the author of our lives. What is the purpose of our life in this kingdom that Jesus and his Father envision for all of us, humanity, his beloved sons and daughters? To glorify God our Creator by our very life. One of the great graces of this pandemic has been to push away distractions that keep us from centering our lives more deeply on God. So he can be more than the center. We've all witnessed during this trying time a mountain of examples of heroic efforts, extraordinary generosity and kindness, the deeper bonds of human communion, the solidarity of feeling and emotion, has drawn us closer together as we share together the struggle. What is all that but the glory of humanity reflecting the Creator's love? You know, we know a lot about Paul's words today, about dying and rising mentioned in the Scriptures, the power of sin and death that's destroyed through the new life arising at baptism. Because in this moment we've seen our spirits die and rise, shifting from death to life, from hope to despair, We have. That's the cross we're bearing during this time. But through all this trouble and all this blessing, we're called to live for God and to live in God. Choices we make in life reflect our real priorities, Jesus reminds us today. The everyday decisions that we make shape what we do, but more importantly, the person that we are. The gospel reveals the great paradox of living for Christ. The more we give away ourselves, physically, materially, our spirits, our presence, our efforts, the more life we find for ourselves. As Pope Francis says, love grows by being given away. Losing our lives, opening our arms and hearts to the needs of others, reaching beyond ourselves, in the spirit of generous love, we discover our true self that God created to glorify our Creator with our lives. Now I'd like to invite everyone to stand as once again we profess what we believe as God's faithful sons and daughters, united in Christ Jesus, our brother and Savior, as we pray together with the Apostles' Creed. You can find it on the screen. Mary is placed there for us. In God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, the Son of the Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified by the Holy Spirit, he descended into hell, on the third day also rose from the dead, he ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty, from there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, communion of saints, forgiveness of sins, and resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Gracious Creator, in the grace of your light and truth, we gather to praise you all our days in Christ our Savior.
our response is glory and praise to you. Complete our church's joy by your presence in our lives.
Glory and praise to you.
Make us faithful messengers of your gospel.
Glory and praise to you.
May our faith community bring hope to our world.
Glory and praise to you.
Have mercy on our sick and struggling sisters and brothers.
Glory and praise to you.
Show your glorious light upon our departed loved ones, remembering Suzette Aquino, Charles and Francis Clark, Francesco Dominica and Regina Di Andrea, Manuel Capomona, Betty Glomsky, Leonard Stancy, Marty Walsh.
Glory and praise to you.
Eternal God, you lead us to the fullness of joy in your Savior Son, Christ, now and forever.
Amen.
Similar way, when they finished the meal together, Jesus took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he shared this chalice with his disciples, and he said, "Take this all, you will drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Feel the Lamb of God, guilty who takes away. away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my life, but only sin, Lord, and my soul shall be. Through the body and blood of Christ, keep us safe for eternal life.
Thank you.
May this divine sacrifice we have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that will last forever in Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I want to tell you how good it is to have you with us. I was reading in one of the priest magazines of one pastor, in fact, several pastors who missed their congregation so much that they had cardboard figures of the actual people, photos of the people they placed all through the pews, but it's not as good as the real thing, all of you. The living Church of God, the community of believers, gathered where we find our life and our goodness and our love in God. And so may you be kept safe, may the Lord stay with you, may he fill you with hope and strength and goodness, and may we together be his faithful disciples, bringing a message of hope and life and strength to our world. Thank you especially to Zumba Group, Jen Adams Zumba Group, and all of those who made such a great sacrifice to feed the people of St. Eulalia, collecting food. Thank you so much. Thank you to those who donate to Salvation Army to feed the need in the community. Thank you to those who are dropping food off for our Tuesday St. Eulalia caravan to feed our sisters and brothers, nourishing them physically but also by our hearts. Let's now ask God's blessing on us to keep us safe and close to him during this time. Lord, bless us, your people, and your faithful family. Fill us with hope and strength. Bring us your goodness and the power of your love always. Make us generous and faithful disciples. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. We go in peace now, strengthened by the Eucharist we have shared together, to love and to joyfully serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.